Let's start with girls' high school lacrosse tonight. The John Marshall Lord Rockets hosted the Owatonna Huskies. Both teams were looking for their first win of the season. The Rockets are in white. Owatonna's Maddie McGinn shoots, and she scores for the first goal of the game. Huskies' Lauren Busho has an answer. She takes it herself, finding the back of the net. Owatonna is up 2-0 in the first, and the Rockets find Luca Neurer right there. She finds the back of the net for JM's first goal of the game. The Huskies won big, though, beating the Rockets 16-3. And switching to the Diamond, softball teams competed today. The Mankato West Scarlets hit the road to face the Century Panthers. The Scarlets are in black tonight, and the Panthers are in navy blue. Century is in the outfield. The pitcher gets the batter swinging for an out right there. The Panthers are up to bat here. A bunt, and she is safe at first base. And then we've got another bunt right here for Century. The throw is overthrown at first, and a Panthers runner scores. The Scarlets got the win, beating the Panthers 8-3. And the Schaefer Academy Lions hosted the Fillmore Central Lanesboro Falcons. Wild pitch by the Lions, bringing in Lydia Penhollow for a Falcons run. And then another wild pitch for Schaefer Academy. Falcons' Haley O'Connor slides into home plate. The Falcons get a convincing victory, knocking off the Lions 15-2. And switching to soccer, let's take a look at a few final scores in North Iowa. On the girls' side, the Garner-Hayfield Ventura Cardinals shut out the Wright County Broncos 4-0. And in boys' high school soccer, the Belmont County Broncos won big over the Garner-Hayfield Ventura Cardinals 6-1. In NCAA women's hoops, Iowa Governor Kim Reynolds has declared today, April 22nd, as Iowa Hawkeyes Women's Basketball Appreciation Day. The Hawkeyes made it to the national championship this season for the second year in a row. The team won the Big Ten championship, sold out arenas, and set viewership records. Governor Reynolds says she wants to congratulate the whole team and its impact on the country this season.
You ladies transformed women's basketball and inspired young girls and boys to dream big, work hard, and believe that they can do anything. Most importantly, you showed all of us what a true champion is.
And two Hawkeye athletes are not done competing. Caitlin Clark was the number one overall pick in the WNBA, joining the Indiana Fever. And Kate Martin will suit up in a Las Vegas Aces jersey. The WNBA season kicks off next week. And the NBA playoffs are here. The three-seeded Minnesota Timberwolves have the sixth seed, the Phoenix Suns, in the first round. The Wolves beat the Suns for the first time this season over the weekend in game one of this series. The Wolves faced the Suns three times in the regular season and lost all of those matchups. But none of that matters in the postseason. Minnesota got the win in game one of the playoffs, beating Phoenix 120-95. Wolves' Anthony Edwards led the team in points with 33. Minnesota center Carl Anthony Towns says the team needs to just stick to their game plan.
They've had our number all year, found a way to get our first win. But you expect them to come back and fire on all cylinders tomorrow. So we got to come back and play two times better than we did game one if we expect to come out with a W in game two.
And game two between the Wolves and the Suns is tomorrow night at the Target Center. Tip-off is set for 6:30.